Okay, so as we've been running so much Crota's End in the group recently, I thought I'd go back and do a solo run, which I've not done for months. Used to run Crota solo numerous times each reset, but I've not done it for maybe 4 or 5 months. Since Christmas, anyway. See how we get on. Feels weird. Okay, so first thing I do, Blade Dancer, full armor, machine gun sniper, and miter. I take these off. So I just thought a few people in the group kind of being interested in potentially trying to run Crota solo, I'd just do a solo run. Just talk about what I have set up, what I don't, what I use, the little tips and tricks and bits and pieces. If I'm not too rusty, it might get flawless, but we'll see. Sections, so always jump, because there is a possibility you can jump down, fall down those cracks. When we drop down here, we'll always spin. I don't know why, it's just something I started doing. And when we get to the point where things slow, I press jump. Now, then I look down again until I see the plate, start spinning again. Found in the past that that kind of saves you from death. Switch away from the armor because you want full agility. Just double check what I've got on. So the things that you want on here are Stalker, so you can crouch and go invis, Escape Artist, and Shadow Jack. Running Miter for the high agility. Sniper, machine gun is the setup I use. The other things that I have on the Blade Dancer is better control rather than higher jump, and certainly not blink skips as well. So we make our way to the first lamp, we go left at the first lamp. I try and get round here, and as I come and hit them through, blade them, go invis, which means I can run past all of these, go right at the second lamp. Make our way to the third lamp. Don't stop us yet. Get to the third lamp. Crouch, go invis. Once I go invis, stand up, move away from the lamp a bit, or the thrall will be behind me. Get to about two. Move forward past the holes. Watch the hole, move forward. Get to the fourth lamp. We're going left, we just wait here. Thrall will be losing. Straight up the hill, don't stop at the next lamp. Go around the rock, watch the hole. The second hole up the hill. Once we get to the next lamp, we crouch and go invis again. We just move in front of the lamp just to shield us from the thrall a little bit. Invis, we're moving forward to the next lamp. No holes in this section. We go left at this lamp. Just gonna wait at this lamp. Should be alright for thrall. Move off. Left at this lamp. We turn around, we're gonna stand through. Just get our weight down to two. Then we're gonna move off down the hill, watch the hole, you run around the hill, hole, down the hill. We're not gonna stop at this lamp because of the night. once we get to this lamp, we're going to go around the back of it. We're going to crouch, go invis. Try and get that weight down to about 2. We're going to keep high, because there's a hole that you can't see. Go down, dodge the holes. We're going right at this lamp. Again, we're going to wait. We're going to crouch. We're going to go invis. We're going to move off. We're going to make our way to the next lamp. We go left at the next lamp. Again, we're trying to get our weight down. Thrall will start coming in. Shoot some thrall this time. Throw a grenade. We're going to watch the night. We're going up the hill here. Just getting our weight down. The night's hit us. We've got Don't Touch Me's on, so we've gone invis. We're keeping left. We're going around the hole. Keeping left. Around the hole. Third from last lamp. We're getting our weight down. Letting the thrall hit us, we'll go invis. Getting our weight right off, and we're moving to the penultimate lamp. Watching the hole. Going left here. Again, thrall will hit us, we'll go invis. We'll make our way to the last lamp. Get to the last lamp, we go to the front of it, we crouch, we go invis. Get our weight right down. Stand back up, get ready to move, run across the plate to activate the bridge. Jump up onto this little section here. This is a bit of a cheese spot that was used in year one. Crawl up to the top of it, throw a skip grenade. Lamp goes off, kills the thrall. We just kill a few thrall, and we wait for ogres. The ogres spawn and come round the right hand side of this lamp. The ogres as soon as we see them. This is the same in hard mode as it is normal mode. Kill the ogre, we'll have two ogres that spawn and kill the thrall. The thrall will totally leave us alone, being up on this cheese spot. Watching for ogres reloading. Alright, for ogres. Switching back to bones. A night stalker. Checking for the ogre. Totally clear. Nearly done. Reload weapons. The bridge is formed. Come off, hit the plate. Sometimes you get an ogre come out this doorway. You have to watch for that. Just make our way forward. There's also a ghost up on that pillar, if you've not got that ghost. It's likely to say Guardian down, that's a glitch in Crota's End. Agility. We're using bones for the 4 jumps that they give us. Night Stalker, this is where I'm going to switch out a bit here because I've not done this for a while. I'm going to pick my agility up. I still want my armour up high. We'll switch that back in a second. This is the bit that I'm always nervous about on Crota. The other thing that I don't want on is Void Wall. Use Void Wall. You obviously want Black Hole, Vanish and Smoke, Light of the Pack. Not that it's particularly relevant. I always use Shade Step, but Predator could be useful. So what we're going to do here, I always jump off of here to go 1, 2, 3 on the jumps. Hit the plate, bring your sniper out. Ignore the ads, jump up onto this box. Get your sniper ready. Headshot. shot the sword bearer. Reload your weapon, bring your mind around, pick up the ascendant sword, jump over these. So that's my four jumps. Run over to this section, jump off onto the box. Now this is where it could go totally wrong. We go jump, 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 and then we're swiping the sword. We're on. Kill the keeper, R2, drop the ascendant sword. Then we go into this section here. We're going to stand here in this corner. We're going to change a subclass out because we want that armor back on. Don't want the agility, don't want the agility. That's the one, so it's bottom and middle. Once we've got that done, we're making sure our weapons are reloaded. Quillums will reload automatically. We're then killing ants. This is, you kill ants, once you've killed enough ants, you'll get wizards and you'll get ogres spawn. I'm going to throw a grenade down there, hopefully that'll deal with those ants. Just basically shoot everything you see, using the shelter of this little pillar. That cursed rule dead, because the cursed rule will creep around the corner. When you're trying to creep out. Once you've killed enough, again, this is a little year one cheat spot that's used by people to solo Crota, because the ants will not follow you around this corner. Another grenade. Okay, we've got a knight over there. We need to be cautious of the knights. We also need to be watching for a wizard coming in from the ogres are already out. Need to get the ogre down. It's a bit unfortunate because he spawned with the wizard. We would like to get the wizard down before the ogre. That ogre's down. We're switching to machine gun. Gonna kill the wizard. Hopefully she won't move. Once the wizard's down, we're good. Reloading sniper. Throwing a tether down. In our rocket. Right, then I switch out to Jury purely because of the Firefly, and I switch out to Sleeper. It's important to have a full Sleeper ammo. Just make sure we're reloaded. The other thing that you must check is reloaded is your sniper. And I'm just waiting for that smoke to build back up, because that smoke grenade could get me out of trouble. Right, so when we run out of here, we're going to go left first. This is the bit I'm nervous about because I've not done it for a while and it can be tricky. So we're going to go straight out, we're going to have our sleeper out and ready. We're going to totally ignore the two knights, we're going to jump over the top. And we're going to go round to the left, jump over this piece of rock. We're going to go up the stairs, a glitch on the stairs. You're going to jump up around the back of this. You'll get a wizard come out. We're going to kill the wizard. We're going to wait for the shrieker to open. We're going to kill the shrieker. And then we're going to jump over the knights. We're going to bring sleeper back out. We're going to reload. We're going to do the same on this side. We're going to go in. The wizard's going to come through. We're going to kill the wizard. Around the back, we're gonna back off. We're gonna go back in. Damn it! Kill the shrieker. Once the shrieker's down, ideally with a sniper rather than sleeper, we're gonna pull back out to this tower. The shrieker blast will stop short. We're going to start working on these knights. Ideally, I want the knights down. The knights normally come out of this doorway. We're not going to push in because it'll irritate the Death Singer. That's a little bit glitchy as well in Crota, because those thrall lads despawn. So just take it out of time. Clearing the ads. This is why I use the rocket. Basically for those ants over there. I've got lots of snipers, so I'm happy to So switching back to blade. Changing. What is it, that one? Changing to max armor. Agility and then recovery. Okay. Leaving it exactly how we had it for the abyss. We change into raise lighter. I like using this because it's got life support on it. More important in hard mode. Still got ads over this side. It's going to be yellow ads over here. Certainly haven't done Crota solo for a few months. This might all go horribly wrong. Once Crota starts to spawn, I'm going to go to this little section here. So I'm sheltered from the right, but I've got eyes on the left. Okay. It's interesting. Out a little bit because it won't let me pick the sword up. So we're just going to drop the sword, we're going to pick, we're going to crouch, we're going up for Crota, we're going to drop the sword, pull out laser light and hit with the sword. Listen. sword bearer's out, so we're gonna pick a sword out. We're gonna crouch, we're gonna go in this. Jump over here. Sword bearer is ideally not where I want him because there's a curse. We're gonna kill the sword. We're gonna pick the relic sword up. We're gonna go up the left side steps. We're gonna jump towards the crystal room. We're gonna crouch. We're gonna rip this. We're gonna go out. We're gonna drop the sword about there. I found the hardest mechanic for doing Crota solo was getting used to using Ray's lighter to bring Crota down. Once you get used to that, it's all good. Right, so I think what we're going to do is... I enjoyed that. How do I share that? I can never remember. God, these menus take ages sometimes. This takes ages on the controller. Particularly when you don't type the right thing. Me. Cool. I'll be honest, I didn't believe I was going to run that flawlessly. does. It makes the spinny noise. I've done it 10 minutes quicker, I've done it 19 minutes and something, but I'm happy with that. It's the first solo I've done for a while, and I didn't think I was going to do that flawless, but I'm quite pleased. Excellent. Okay, I think I'm going to leave the stream there for this evening.